Thank you.
What would you say you have learned from your work in this lab?
It takes a village. It takes a group working together to make it all happen.
I am Aaron Souza. I am an electrical engineer.
My name is Maureen Kennelly. I'm a marine research specialist.
I'm Allie Johnson. I'm a PhD student and I study physical oceanography.
I'm Randy Watts. I'm a professor of oceanography.
I am Laura Reed. I'm a marine research specialist.
My name is Kathy Donahue. I'm a professor of oceanography. And in oceanography, I have a lot of different roles. But within the lab, my main role, I think, is a navigator.
We're the ocean storms people. We design, build, deploy, and analyze the data from instruments that study storms in the ocean.
You think of the deep ocean as, I guess, boring, quiet, but there is always something going on. There's always some signal in there.
View of the ocean has changed a lot into one of looking at kind of the ocean as a steady state system to one that is actually full of storms. Their dynamics are very similar to what the storms in the atmosphere are, and they play a huge role in how the ocean moves heat around.
We use these instruments called CPIs. CPI stands for Current and Pressure Recording Inverted Echo Sounders.
There's a glass sphere, 17-inch sphere. It's a half an inch thick glass. Comes in two hemispheres. We add wires, cables, electronics. We send these oceanographic instruments to the bottom of the ocean, 3,000, 5,000 meters down.
Sound is used extensively in oceanography, and ships need to know how much water is below them, so they use depth sounders and they send out acoustic signals to bounce off the ocean floor and figure out how much water is below them. The inverted echo sounder actually works very much in the same way, except it's sitting on the bottom and looking at the surface.
So we send out a sound from the bottom and we measure the time it takes for that sound to go from the bottom to the surface and come back to the instrument.
Turns out this sound speed in water is mainly dependent on temperature, so it's getting this sort of average temperature in the seawater.
In order to understand how our climate system works and how the ocean plays into our climate system, we have to understand where the heat is and where it's going and how it's being distributed.
It's kind of like a weather map for the ocean. That's what we're producing.
I think ultimately our lab is trying to address the ocean's role in climate. The whole reason why we have wind and storms and currents moving is because we have to move excess heat from the equator to the poles. The atmosphere wants to be in equilibrium. It doesn't want to be hot at the tropics and cool at the poles. And so trying to establish that equilibrium is why we basically have weather. You know, we're a really diverse group of people. We have a lot of special talents. And so when we come together, it's a little bit sometimes like a jigsaw puzzle, right? Like, how do we pull out the best in each of us so that we can achieve the goal that we set out for?
This sort of the way our lab works is one way or another, whether or not things go bad or things go wrong or something happens, we get it done and we get the data and results that we're looking for.
I really enjoy it when things work. I really enjoy it when the equipment works, but I also enjoy it when I get the opportunity to fix the equipment and make it work.
We build instruments primarily, and then we use those instruments in our own research, but we also build them for other investigators.
And we help other people do that too around the world with making these instruments for them and getting them prepared and out to them. And I think that that's a really cool thing. And it's also really cool how globally connected our little lab is. There's only a handful of us.
It's effective enough that it's been adopted in essentially all major oceanographic institutions around the globe now. We train their technicians and their students to work with the data. So quite powerful, and there's so many more questions that they can help answer.
I think for me, what's been amazing about a career in oceanography is the people that I've been able to work with and collaborate with and exist with. You know, people that are super creative, people that are resilient, sort of optimistic. I think anyone who wants to put instruments into the ocean, leave them, and then come back to them are ultimately optimists.
Be able to pull up these instruments that have been sitting on the bottom of the ocean for 2 years and have them work perfectly is still mind-blowing to me every time it happens successfully.